last week at the technical part of the Stocktake, we heard the following. The presiding officers of the subsidiary bodies, vice chair of the CDM executive board and the high-level champion spoke about the efforts of the UNFCCC process related to reducing emissions. Representatives from the constituent bodies provided detailed examples of how their bodies or organizations enhance climate implementation and ambition. On finance, almost half of the submissions referred to the commitment undertaken by developed country parties to the goal of mobilizing jointly $100 billion annually by 2020 to address the needs of developing countries. Developed countries need to scale up their provision on finance to close the gap. Many parties pointed out that more comprehensive information on their pre-2020 efforts can be found in their latest national communication, biennial report, or biennial update report. Many parties pointed out that more comprehensive information on their pre-2020 efforts can be found in their latest national communication, biennial report, or biennial update report.
The European Union has put in place an ambitious mix of pre-2020 targets, but also, and this is very important, of the structural policies in the field of climate and energy. And our actions have resulted in the European Union already exceeding our 2020 target under the Kyoto Protocol, which was to reduce emissions by 20% from 1990. The intra-European coverage of the emission trading system has delivered around 100 million tons CO2 of reductions and offsets between 2012 and 2018. The European Union remains committed to the collective goal of developed countries of mobilizing $100 billion a year in climate finance by 2020 and through to 2025 for climate action in developing countries in the context of meaningful mitigation actions and transparency on implementation. We should open the door to all solutions and initiatives, including from regions, cities, companies, trade unions, civil society, and faith-based organizations. And to unlock this potential, we all need to raise awareness of the benefits of climate actions, draw out the good examples, learn from each other, and work together on enhancing implementation. We have the highest expectation of what non-state actors can achieve, and we need the local knowledge, creativity, and lessons from all actors, and the next step to scale up this kind of climate action across the board.